So we have on the one hand this machine learning approach where we don't necessarily understand how it works.
This is Boi Faltings, a food professor of the IC school at EPFL.
Where we sometimes maybe get some errors where, you know, the results of the reasoning are not really predictable, so that we always have to live with a bit of error rate.
This is something important to keep in mind. You should not trust machine learning the same way as you would trust well-studied hand-written algorithms. Well-known hand-written algorithms can be proved to be mathematically correct. But at least so far, we have not found a systematic way to guarantee the correctness of machine learning algorithms.
Imagine if you go to the supermarket checkout, you know, if it's run by a machine learning trained neural net, then, well, you know, 1 in 100 times your bill will just be wrong, you know, so it might have added a few francs here or taken a few francs off in your favor. Anyway, we are not used to checking the bill at the supermarket. So we expect computers to be right all the time, to be really accurate.
So how can we guarantee the reliability of AI without sacrificing performance?
Bringing these two cultures together is actually a challenge because computer science has always been based on mathematics and on proving that things are correct, that my program will produce the correct output every time for whatever input I feed it. Whereas the neural nets, well, they're just devices. So, well, some percent of the time it will be wrong, but most of the time it will be right, and they can do very complex things. But we have to live with this error, this margin of error.
So the big question
is there a way that we can somehow bring the two together so that we can benefit from all this power of neural nets in recognizing speech, recognizing things in images and so on, and the reliability of computer programs as we traditionally built them?
It's a tough one.
I think there's still a lot to be done in that direction, and I think that's where we can really see a big advance in the artificial intelligence and intelligence that helps us go beyond to where we can go now. And one example of that is the AlphaGo program of Google DeepMind.
You've almost definitely heard of that. In 2016, Google DeepMind created an AI called AlphaGo, which successfully defeated Lee Sedol, one of the top players in the world at the game of Go. This was very dramatic, as most AI experts used to believe that it would take many more decades before beating humans at the game of Go.
So people have been trying to build Go programs based on deep neural nets for many years, but they were never competitive with other Go programs. So the performance, it was never possible to achieve performance that was good enough.
So how did Google DeepMind do it?
Now what they AlphaGo team realized is that you should take the best AI approach, which is based on search. It's similar to chess programs. You imagine all the possible sequences of moves, or at least you sample a large number of them, and then you pick the best one. So, which is a more explicit reasoning approach. You can use the neural nets in that approach to suggest the best moves, to use as heuristics, so that would make this process work faster, find a good solution faster. But the real solution is still found by something that's more verifiable and that's more explicable.
Basically, as opposed to what you might have heard in mainstream media coverage, deep learning was only a part of AlphaGo. AlphaGo was actually mostly made of classical AI algorithms to compute its moves, including a Monte Carlo tree search algorithm. And deep learning was merely a component of AlphaGo, albeit an important one, to help accelerate and improve the Monte Carlo tree search.
So similarly, we could actually imagine a lot of applications of AI, more traditional type AI, that would benefit from deep neural nets, in order to speed up their reasoning, in order to maybe suggest new knowledge that could be used in reasoning as well. So we could actually have quite a range of new applications that maybe will be a lot more powerful than what we had before.
In fact, such techniques are being developed at IBM, where an AI called Watson is being created and optimized to improve medical diagnostics and prescriptions.
Watson is another example of a system that is really based on knowledge-based, you know, logical reasoning techniques, and is quite successful. And with Watson, again, you have this possibility to always explain what happened. So it's a very transparent process.
What are the next big applications of AI?
This is the future, and we're working on it. And come back to the space in a few years.
So instead of having to consider hundreds of different moves at each step of the search, it just considers maybe a handful of promising moves that are suggested by this policy network.
And so in Bayesian reasoning, I actually say I will compute this based on a prior, and then every piece of information that I collect allows me to update this belief.